You love Star Wars? We love Star Wars? Everyone loves the Star Wars universe. It spawned 7 films with more on the way, cartoons, video games, and so much merchandise. All of which has made billions and billions of dollars for the film studios and George Lucas. Given all the Star Wars information that's out there, you'd think everyone would know everything about all the films that have been released. Think again. So sit back and enjoy 10 surprising facts about Star Wars movies that you never knew. Klaatu Barada Nictu. If you utter the words Klaatu Barada Nictu in a crowded room, most people will say bless you. The cool kids will know you're referencing Army of Darkness, where Ash is unable to correctly pronounce the phrase that pays and accidentally unleashes the Legion of the Dead. The cooler kids will know you're referencing the 1951 film The Day the Earth Stood Still and how those three little words saved the entire planet. The coolest kids will know you're referring to three of Jabba the Hutt's henchmen in Return of the Jedi. George Lucas decided to pay homage to the sci-fi classic by naming three aliens who accompanied Jabba on his skiff to the Sarlacc pit. While their names are never mentioned on screen, they weren't listed in the credits. So, pop your collar and put on your shades. You're one of the coolest kids now. Wilro Hood, Badass Bespin. Several of the blink-and-you-miss-them characters from Star Wars have been given extensive backstories by fans. While most of them are only known to the most diehard fanatics, some become legendary. For example, Wilro Hood, a random guy in the background during the escape from Cloud City in The Empire Strikes Back. We're not sure why the extra in the scene grabbed an ice cream maker before the scene was shot, but we're glad he did. Even though he only appears on screen for 2 seconds, we know that Wilro was a miner who became a hero by making sure that Darth Vader didn't get his hands on the computer core containing the identity of members of the Rebellion. Or he really loved delicious frozen treats and wanted to make sure he could always have some wherever in the galaxy he ended up. Bickering Buddies. Everyone knows that C-3PO and R2-D2 have a contentious relationship in the Star Wars universe, but did you know that the actors who portray the robot BFFs really didn't like each other? Though they had very little interaction with each other on set, Anthony Daniels, who plays C-3PO, and Kenny Baker, R2-D2, seemed to appreciate that fact. When they did talk, it was usually bitter quips and rude glances. Prior to his recent death, Baker maintained that Daniels was the reason for all of the backbiting, claiming Daniels thought he was a golden gift to George Lucas, while Baker was only capable of beeping and booping. Sounds like upsetting a droid might be worse than a Wookiee. Hamilton Helps. There are a lot of fans of Hamilton, a hip-hop musical based on the life and times of one of America's founding fathers, Alexander Hamilton. If you haven't seen it, you should do so right now. Well, wait until this video is over, but then make plans to see Lin-Manuel Miranda's amazing production. One of the superfans of the Broadway show was J.J. Abrams, the director of The Force Awakens. When J.J. needed new music for the cantina scene in The Force Awakens, he called on Miranda's musical talents to spice up Maz Kanata's dive bar. The catchy tune, titled Jabba Flow, played as Han, Finn, and Rey start their journey to find Luke. While the music mainly exists in the background, the song has become so popular, several musical acts have covered or remixed it. Face Off. In January of 1977, Mark Hamill was driving along a deserted highway when he lost control of his vehicle, fracturing his nose and cheek as a result of the accident. Director George Lucas needed a few reshoots of Star Wars A New Hope, so he used an extra and only filmed the replacement actor from behind, so his face would not be seen. However, in The Empire Strikes Back, the cast and crew would need to be even more creative to explain the differences in Mark Hamill's features. They needed a Wampa. The scene where Luke is captured by a Wampa while out on the Tauntaun stroll was rearranged, placing it much earlier in the movie than intended. By doing so, they could easily explain why Luke's face had changed. Well, that and 3 years on the run from Darth Vader and his Sith pals. Prequel Casting Carousel. It's hard to imagine any other actors in the Star Wars movies, but several big-named actors were almost cast in some of your favorite roles. The baddest mother effing Jedi in the galaxy, Mace Windu, was played by Samuel L. Jackson, but two other stars auditioned. The late rapper-turned-actor Tupac Shakur and actor Owen Wilson. We can't imagine either one of them in the role, but Tupac does make a convincing hologram. This wasn't the only role up for grabs in the prequels, as everyone's favorite Gungan was almost played by the King of Pop, Michael Jackson. George Lucas wanted the role to be motion-captured, creating the first CGI lead character, having Best act out the scenes in a getup that slightly resembles Binks. Jackson actively pursued the role, but only if he could wear full makeup and prosthetics while shooting. Vader's Many Faces. Speaking of actors playing iconic roles, no role in the Star Wars universe has been played by more actors than Anakin Skywalker. The promising Jedi who heads down a dark path has been portrayed on film by 6 actors. David Prowse wore the outfit of Darth Vader during all 3 of the original films. However, director George Lucas decided Vader's voice needed more gravitas and cast James Earl Jones to provide the iconic voice. In addition, Prowse was awful with pretend swords, so he was replaced in the costume by stuntman Bob Anderson during lightsaber fights. Due to a falling out between Prowse and Lucas, actor Sebastian Shaw filmed the famous scenes of Luke removing Darth's helmet. Playing the role of Anakin Skywalker as a young lad was Jake Lloyd, and playing Anakin as a bratty teenager went to Hayden Christensen. Jake Lloyd is currently dealing with legal trouble, and Christensen basically quit acting. So good luck, Spencer Wilding, who will be actor number 7 as he plays Darth Vader in Rogue One. The Other Side of A New Hope. In the months before its May 1977 release, Star Wars A New Hope had a swelling budget and bad word of mouth. 20th Century Fox was getting nervous that they wouldn't make any money on a space drama filled with glowing swords. The studio was also getting ready to release its big summer film, The Other Side of Midnight. Theater owners scoffed at the idea of Star Wars, but the studio forced their hands. If they wanted to book The Other Side of Midnight, they had to take Star Wars as well. Since we're assuming you've never heard of the tale of love and revenge set during World War II, you probably know what happened. The Other Side still managed to make a very impressive, by late 70s standards, $19 million, while Star Wars made about $240 million during its first run and became a global phenomenon we're still talking about today. That other bounty hunter. Everyone knows the name of Boba Fett, the notorious bounty hunter who's rather easily dispatched by a blind Han Solo into the Sarlacc pit. What you may not remember is Darth Vader dispatched several bounty hunters to capture members of the rebellion, including a robot assassin named IG-88. This metallic badass was listed in the script as Chrome War Droid, and referred to as Flute Droid during filming, eventually getting letters and numbers like the rest of the droids. Needing parts to build the robot, the production designers were unable to locate the pieces they needed, so they did what they had to do and tore apart the Mos Eisley Cantina drink dispenser to make the robot. While future patrons of the Cantina were unable to get drinks, we're glad they recycle in a galaxy far, far away. Bad feelings. Fans have been quoting Star Wars since its release, but no line may be more memorable than,
"I have a bad feeling about this."
A version of that line has been uttered in every Star Wars movie made, and has even made its way into the video game and cartoon spin-offs. Harrison Ford loved the phrase so much, he even used it in Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. While people have had bad feelings all the time, we're pretty sure every time you hear this phrase in a movie or TV show, it's because of Star Wars. The Star Wars universe is vast and growing every year. With so many films, TV shows, video games, comics, and more, it can be hard to keep track of every piece of information about the films. Hopefully, we've provided you with a few facts that you can impress your friends with. Did we miss any details that you know about? Let us know. If you like this video and want to see more, subscribe to our channel, give this video a thumbs up, and share it with your friends. Be sure to leave a comment telling us the Star Wars trivia we missed.